Look at me. You may think you see who I really am, but you'll never know me. Every day it's as if I play a part. Now I see, if I wear a mask, I can fool the world, but I cannot fool my heart. Oh, it's that girl I see, staring straight back at me. When will my reflection show who I am inside? It's a heart that must be free to fly, that burns with a need to know the reason why. Must we open, see what we think and how we feel? Must there be a secret me I'm forced to hide? I won't pretend that I'm someone else for all time. When will my reflection show who I am inside? When
Let us pray the Lowesian prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, wellspring of goodness and blessings, we give you thanks and praise as one Lowesian community. The graces you incessantly grant upon us and your divine providence have sustained our beloved university throughout the years of mission and excellence. Having been founded by the Congregation of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, we pray that you keep us committed and dedicated to our mission and identity to serve the Church and the society, as we become living witnesses to the gospel values proclaimed by Jesus. For if we are steadfast in our good and beautiful mission, our works will bring success not only to ourselves, but also to those whom we are bound to love and serve. Inspired by Saint Louis, our patron saint, who was filled with a noble spirit to steer him to love you above all things, may we also live believing that we are born for a greater purpose and mission, as we dwell in your presence all the days of our life. Grant all these supplications through the intercession of Mother Mary and through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good morning, Lewisian Gems. I am Krisha, and today I'm going to teach you how to say good morning in Korean. To say good morning in Korean, just simply say, Jeon Achim. Jeowon means good, Achim means morning. And to say good morning in a formal way, just say, Jeon Achim Yipnida. That's all. Thank you.
Good day, Lewisian Gems. Welcome back to our YouTube channel. I am your Mama Loki, your lecturer for week 1 of the final term. By the way, congratulations for doing your best during the midterm examinations. Last midterms, you were introduced to the different aspects of communication and you were given different performance tasks. This final term expects that there will be different activities which will require you to upload a video of yourself. For this lecture, the following are our learning objectives. At the end of the lesson, you should be able to in the course of communication, we frequently encounter problems caused by linguistic recycling. Communicative strategies are strategies used to address these problems in order to have a successful communication. There are 7 communicative strategies. These are nomination, turn taking, topic shifting, topic control, restriction, termination, and the last one is the repair.
The first communicative strategy is nomination. So when introducing a topic at the beginning of a communicative situation, what is being used is the nomination strategy. A speaker carries out nomination to collaboratively and productively establish a topic. Now let's have an example.
Good day, everyone. Today, I am going to share to you our plans for the recognition.
Good morning, sir. May I disturb you for a while? May I ask where is the guidance office?
This way, sir.
Thank you.
Now, here is a question which I would like you to answer. Why is nomination an effective communication strategy for smooth relations within a community or organization? The next strategy is turn-taking. It pertains to the process by which people decide who takes the conversational floor. Speakers speak only when it is his or her turn during interaction. So it uses either an informal approach, just jump in and start talking, or a formal approach wherein you are given permission to speak or you are requested to speak. Okay, so kindly watch the given example.
This time, may we now listen to the new ideas of Sir Brian.
Ma'am, I would like to recommend Mr. Darwin Dumlao to be our guest speaker.
I cannot locate my data.
You know what, there's so...
Let's go, because let's talk one after the other first. Okay, let's hear out Iya first.
Okay.
Now, what does give and take mean as it pertains to communication? The next strategy is topic shifting. Topic shifting is a communicative strategy that is useful in introducing another topic. This strategy works best when there is a follow-through so that new topic continues to be discussed. Now, let's have an example.
Hey guys, I think we should follow the protocol of our school.
Yes, I agree.
Me too.
By the way, guys, do you know that we already have a new set of SSG officers? I saw it posted on the page of the senior high school.
Really?
Yeah.
So the next strategy is restriction. Restriction is a communicative strategy that constrains or restricts the response of the other person involved in the communication situation. The listener is forced to respond only within a set of categories that is made by the speaker. So in simple words, the participant, or let's say the receiver, is not allowed to speak unless the facilitator or the sender of the message allows this person to interact in the communication process. Now, kindly watch the example.
Okay, class, so during our teleconference, kindly mute yourselves. You may only unmute if you are recognized to recite.
Now, why is there a need for restriction in a society, especially this time of pandemic? The next strategy is topic control. Topic control covers how procedural formality and informality affects the development of topics in conversation. It is used to maintain conversation and it tries to prevent unnecessary discussions or interruptions, or it simply tries to avoid topic shifting during the conversation. Now let's have this example.
In this scenario, the teacher is discussing a lesson in class through a group chat.
Then suddenly, Ariel asked if he could have an announcement in class. Since the teacher doesn't want to be interrupted, she mentioned that Ariel can have the announcement after the class. So the teacher controlled the participants in order to avoid topic shifting in class.
Okay, another strategy is repair. It refers to how the speaker addresses the problems in speaking, listening, and comprehending that they may encounter in a conversation. It is actually a good way of correcting oneself and giving also the speaker to correct himself or herself if it happens that he or she committed a mistake. Now, let's have this example.
Okay, guys, so those are the four functions of communication.
Mom, excuse me.
Yes.
I think there are five functions of communication.
Yes, you're right. Thank you for that.
So here is another question. What is the best way to correct someone's mistake? Lastly, we have termination. So termination communicative strategy ends the interaction through verbal and nonverbal messages that both speaker and listener send to each other. Sometimes the termination is quick and short. Sometimes it is also prolonged by clarification, further questions, or the continuation of the topic already discussed. But the point of the language and body movement is simply to end the communication process. Okay, so let's have this example.
Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you so much for listening.
Goodbye, ma'am, and thank you so much.
Those are the different communicative strategies. I hope that you'll be able to apply both in your own life, especially when you communicate with someone. Once again, this is your mom, Mo Lovely. Thank you so much for listening. Good luck and God bless.